Do you have any tips of how to even go about that? That's a big step for pet owners to try to figure out, okay, well, where do I take my puppy and how do I make sure that those experiences are going to be positive?
It is a big step and it's a limited time window.
Yeah.
You know, I'll have people say, I'm ready to socialize my dog and he's two. I'm like, oh,
right.
A little late. So we're really aiming for 12 weeks. You do have to be safe. You want to make sure that you carry hypoallergenic wipes to wipe the puppy's feet if he's going to be where other dogs have been. You want to avoid certain areas that unvaccinated dogs may have been. So when I say socialization, I mean the things that I said before, making sure your puppy has all those wonderful experiences with different types of people and different ethnicities and all those things. A lot of people think socialization means other dogs. And they do need to be exposed to other dogs, but in a very safe manner. So we're never going to go to a dog park with a puppy. Please don't ever do that. Please don't ever do that. You can't control anything. Everybody at the dog park is doing this. They're like, they're not paying attention to their dog attacking your dog. They're not paying attention if their dog is aggressive or having a bad time. So you don't want to go to a dog park. That's not what socialization is all about. I love taking dogs to stores that allow dogs. I put a towel in the bottom of the cart and I make sure that they're still on a leash because I've had a few puppies try to leap out of the cart even while it's in motion.
Right.
So I want to make sure we're secure. And we go tooling around that store and with cookies just rain from the sky. We have lots of treats and lots of cookies and someone's going to come up and go, what a cute puppy. Here, give him a cookie. If the puppy is not having a good time, if the puppy is not taking treats, if the puppy is just sleeping through the whole experience, that puppy is shut down. And that means that you've overwhelmed that puppy. So some puppies need to start in the parking lot, maybe in the car, you know, propped in the window, again, secured so they can't jump out. And maybe we just look at the world from the safety of the car for a while until we get more comfortable. And then maybe we hang out front of the store until that puppy gets comfortable. And then we have the ability to go inside. And I just want to add that that may not be in the same session. That may be 5 sessions. That may be 10. It depends on the puppy and the puppy gets to decide what he's afraid of. So I like to go to stores with puppies. I like to go in the neighborhood. I like to invite people over, have puppy parties. I don't want to have 30 people over at one time. That's a lot. But, you know, you want to stagger that. You want to have a couple people over, then another couple people over, then another couple people over. Exposing that puppy to people who are regularly in and out of your home. If you have gardeners, if you have the air conditioning guy coming, if you've got landscape folks, we want to make sure that that puppy is exposed to that and finds them to be friendly and wonderful and not scary.
And I like your idea about stores too, because so many stores are pet friendly now. If you just ask and make sure they're comfortable with it, what better way to socialize your puppy? You're going to meet a lot of people when you're in a store with a puppy.
Exactly. Exactly. There's so many people. And even if you don't have people that want to come up to your puppy is learning how to navigate, you know, sounds, you know, loudspeakers and carts and, children. And there's usually a wide variety. Even if you go outside a grocery store parking lot, there's all sorts of people that come to the grocery store. And so there's just a variety of people that are there that can either interact with your puppy or your puppy can experience and get cookies the whole time to make sure that he's having a good time.
And like you said, the puppy is the one who decides. So it's not us who decides, well, this looks cute. And this looks like it's going to make a good like social media photo. So it must be socialization.
So it's all for Facebook. In the Insta. We got to do it. Right. Well, I'm going to have my puppy pose with the entire cheerleading squad.
Yeah.
Because, well, the puppy, you know, looks stricken in the photo. This is why we dog trainers are never fun on social media sometimes because we're like, that puppy's not happy. Yeah. Why did you post that picture? Don't hug it. Don't hug the puppy.
We can't help ourselves.